किसने शेयर किया?
मैडम हो गया
बोला ना, ऑडिएबल
हाँ
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग।
मैं कुछ नहीं
तो इधर ही सुन लो ना, अपने मोबाइल में क्यों सुन रहे हो मैडम? काय लगा रहे हो? नहीं तो ये यूज कर रहे हो। रुको ना, ये फोन किस पे? माइक पे नहीं कर रहा।
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
यूट्यूब वर नहीं जाते आवाज।
What happened to my tablet?
मैं होस्ट हूँ चालू
नहीं किसी का नहीं मैडम मैंने समय डालते हैं आपको
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम
A very good morning to all the respected teachers and students. I, Madhuri Pandey, assistant professor. Hello?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, there is disturbance in your.
A very good morning.
There is disturbance.
Okay. A very good morning to all the respected teachers and students. I, Madhuri Pandey, assistant professor, on behalf of Genpa Sopan Rao Muse College of Pharmacy, Waghuli, welcome you all the delegates in the session. Here we have organized a pre-webinar based on techniques and practical of chromatography, techniques and practice of chromatography in collaboration with Anchrome Enterprises, Mumbai. Now we will move to the technical session with the introduction of our beloved speaker for the day. With immense pleasure, I welcome Mrs. Mugdha Nandirkar ma'am for the session. I am honored to introduce her with you all. Nandirkar ma'am has completed her M.Pharmacy in Pharmaceutical Analysis from Bangalore University and MBA in Human Resource Management from Nasik University. She has 6 years of academic experience and she has also worked as a guide for a number of students in research area. There are about 20 publications on her name in research and review field. Now, she is working as assistant professor in Genpa Sopan Rao Muse College of Pharmacy, Waghuli. Now, I request Professor Mugdha Nandirkar to begin with our session. Thank you.
Good morning, delegates.
Good morning.
Am I audible?
Ma'am.
Yes,
yes,
ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, first of all, I would like to extend my thanks to our respected principal, Dr. Rajesh Oswal, sir, for giving me this opportunity to be a speaker for a pre-webinar session that is titled with techniques and practice of chromatography. So the main aim for conducting this pre-webinar is that our college for the first time, Genpa Sopan Rao Muse College of Pharmacy, Waghuli, for the first time has collaborated with the industry to conduct a webinar. So that industry is Anchrome Enterprises Private Limited, Mumbai. This industry is specialized in HPTLC, that is high performance thin layer chromatography. So to make a basic concepts clear regarding the chromatography, this webinar has been arranged. So let's move towards chromatography. So first of all, I would like to clear with the term chromatography. The chromatography means separation technique. I hope everyone is familiar with the word separation, as this word we are using in day-to-day life. separate, right? To get the separate. So separation technique, whenever these words come, chromatography, it means it deals with the separation technique, right? So for the newcomers to the pharmacy field, that is first year D pharmacy and first year B pharmacy, including second year also, second year D pharm and second year B pharm students, the chromatography, get familiar with the word chromatography as the industrial person is going to elaborate their techniques on 10th March, which will be a techniques and application of HPTLC. So before moving towards what is HPTLC, we will see what is chromatography, right? So this is a separation technique. So the history of chromatography is he is a scientist who used a chromatography to separate the plant pigments, right? So whatever the pigments that is present in the plant, he used the plant pigment and separate the medicinal elements or medicinal molecules from the plant. So he discovered a colorful separation of plant pigments, which was done by using a column chromatography. So he used a calcium carbonate, a chalk powder. With the help of chalk powder, he separated the pigments from the plants. So it is a new technique, what's called chromatography. Chromatography, this word is derived from a Greek word that is chroma and graphians. So chroma is nothing but color and graphians means write. Okay, means writing in color is known as chromatography. It is derived from the Greek word chroma and graphians. Is it clear what is chromatography? First it will come. It is a separation technique which deals with the writing in color. Means we will obtain a result which will be visible in a color form. Right, different colors will be visible as a result. So am I clear with what do you mean with the term chromatography? It is a separation technique. First, very basic concept, it is a separation technique. There are n numbers of chromatography techniques which deals under the chromatography, that is paper chromatography, TLC, that is thin layer chromatography, then HPTLC, that is high performance thin layer chromatography, then HPLC, that is high performance liquid chromatography, gas chromatography. Like this, there are number of different chromatographic techniques that can deal with separation. The motto of chromatography technique, using the different instruments, is just for separation, right? And also to study the molecular formula, to study the or to invent the new drug into the market, we need to identify the drug molecules, the elements present into the drug molecules. So for the study, it plays a very vast role in research industries or in development industries, so that a new molecule can be invented into the market. So for each and every chromatography, wherever the word comes chromatography, that means a separation technique by which a result is visible with the colors, right? Different colors will identify or will help to show the presence of the different molecules present into the drug element. So is it clear with the term chromatography?
Yes, ma'am.
Now we'll see the principle, basic principle that deals with the simple chromatography. We are not using any kind of instruments such as paper, TLC, HPLC. We are just seeing what is the principle behind chromatography. So this deals with the technique used to separate and identify the components of a mixture. Okay, so two things we obtain from chromatography. First, we can separate the drug molecule from a complex mixture, and secondly, we can identify the components. What components we are getting separate, we obtain in a separate manner. So what molecule, what components are present, we can identify those. So the chromatography works by allowing the molecule present in the mixture to distribute themselves between stationary phase and mobile phase. So before moving towards principle, I would like to explain you each and every chromatography techniques that deals with two phases, compulsory with two phases. Without this two phase, chromatographic separation cannot be takes place. So what are those components? So first is mobile phase, right? So mobile phase, as the name indicates, mobile, right? It is moving. It should be moving. So the solvent that flows throughout the system is known as mobile phase, right? So make it very clear for the first year, second year, it is a very basic concept you need to understand so that it will be easier for you to study analysis subject in higher classes, that is in third year as well as in final year. Also, it is very important from point of view of industry, because each and every industry deals with the chromatography techniques for identifying and separation of the mixture. So wherever the words come, chromatography means it deals with the two components. What are those? Those are, first is mobile phase and second is stationary phase. So as I said earlier, mobile phase, as the name indicates, mobile means it should be moving, or it is moving phase. Okay, it flows throughout the procedure or throughout the instrument. Right? So this is a mobile phase, and second term is stationary phase. Stationary phase, it is a fixed phase. It is not non-moving. Are you getting me? Stationary phase, it is a fixed phase in which a part of chromatography system, it is fixed in the place. Right? So this is stationary phase. So mobile phase is moving, while stationary phase is non-moving. It is a fixed phase, right? Is it clear with the components of chromatography? Now we'll move towards supporting medium. So this stationary phase, as it is a fixed phase, so we need to coat the element by using a medium, supporting medium. So we use different adsorbents to which the drug molecules will get attached to the adsorbents, or they get absorbed. So different supporting mediums are used, such as silica gel, alumina gel, or cellulose. So these are the supporting medium. This also plays an important role in chromatography, in separation of chromatography. So supporting medium is nothing but a solid surface on which a stationary phase is bound or coated, right? So to stationary phase, we are coating a supporting medium to attract the molecules, to identify those molecules. Okay, so this deals with three components, that is mobile phase, stationary phase, and supporting medium. So mobile phase is nothing but it is moving. It should move throughout the chromatographic separation. Then stationary phase, it is a fixed phase. It is non-moving. And supporting medium means we are using, with the help of supporting medium, we are coating the stationary phase to move the particles through the stationary phase. All right. So these are the main components with the deals with the chromatographic techniques. Each and every chromatography techniques will have mobile phase, stationary phase, and supporting medium. So again, chromatography is nothing but a separation technique by which color elements. We will observe the result in colors. And each and every chromatography technique deals with phases, three components, that is mobile phase, stationary phase, and supporting medium. Is it clear to all participants? Question and answer session I will be conducting at the last, so that you can ask me your question at last session. If you have any of the queries during the webinar, you can note down in your notebook and later you can ask me. Okay. So again, we'll see what happens in chromatography. So it allows the molecule to present in the mixture to distribute themselves in the stationary phase and mobile phase. So whatever drug molecule we are taking for separation, so this chromatography technique, it allows the molecule to pass through mobile phase as well as stationary phase. This stationary phase is coated with the supporting medium by using the different adsorbents such as silica gel, alumina, and cellulose. With this adsorbents, we can we coat this adsorbent on the stationary medium. So molecules that spend most of their time in the mobile phase are carried along faster. Means the molecule which spend their time with mobile phase, as I said earlier, mobile phase is always the moving one, right? So whichever particles or drug molecules or elements which have affinity with the mobile phase, that will get elute fast from the chromatographic separation, right? So these are the components: mobile phase, stationary phase, and supporting medium. Now we'll see what these are the basic terms which comes for chromatographic separation, that is adsorption. As I said, adsorption, it helps the molecule to get attract on the adsorbed material that is coated on the stationary phase. So here interaction of the solute molecules will takes place with the help of adsorbent, different adsorbent. Then what is eluent? Eluent is nothing but the mobile phase, which is moving one. Okay. Then what is elution? That is motion of mobile phase through the stationary phase. Once we are allowing the mobile phase to run into the instrument, so at that time when we start or when we inject the liquid, that is known as mobile phase. Okay, once we inject the liquid, that is known as mobile phase. But when it gets interact with the stationary phase, it same liquid is to be said as elution, right? Because here what happens, the adsorbents which is present on the stationary phase, then this mobile phase will get interact with the stationary phase, and here the interaction of the molecules which is present into the drug sample, that will takes place, and through which the mobile phase will get out from the instrument. Okay, so that is known as elution. Mobile phase, when initially we inject, it is known as mobile phase, but once that solution when gets interaction with the drug molecule and stationary phase, then it is said to be elution. Then again, elution time, again same, the time required to get the liquid out of the instrument, it is known as elution time, the time taken for a solute to pass through the system, right? Then a solute with a short elution time travels through the stationary phase rapidly. This concept I will again explain you in upcoming slides very clearly. Then we'll see stationary phase. Again, it is a part of chromatography system that is fixed in place, right? Stationary phase is non-moving. It is fixed at place. Then reverse phase, it is a modified stationary phase where polar solutes run fast, right? So again, what is polarity? What is polar non-polar solvents or molecules? So in chemistry, polarity refers to the distribution of electric charge around atoms, molecules or chemical group is known as polarity. Means what? Electric charge, plus minus charge is distributed into the atoms is known as polarity. So now we'll see what are polar molecules and non-polar molecules. Very basic terms. I guess this you have studied in 12th science. So polar molecules are nothing. There is an electronegativity differs between the bonded atoms, right? It is unequal distribution of the charges in on the atoms is known as polar molecules, right? And non-polar molecules means this occurs when electrons are shared equally between the atoms is known as non-polar molecules. Is it clear? So this polarity plays a very important role while selection of mobile phase, because there are again n number of solvents are present. So which solvent we have to select for our separation technique, that will depend upon the polarity. So we have seen what is polar molecules and non-polar molecules, right? In polar molecules, the electronegativity charges are unequally distributed, is known as polar, while non-polar means the electrons are distributed equally between the atoms. Is it clear? What is polarity, polar molecules and non-polar molecules? This plays an important role of selection for mobile phase. Now we'll move towards our basic concept, that is classification of chromatography. Right? As I said earlier, there are a number of instruments for chromatography. So again, this is depends upon the principle. There are various principle. Each and every instruments plays a has a different principle, that is absorption and partition, right? The chromatography separation takes place with the principle of adsorption or separation. So depending upon this classification means chromatography is classified on based on instrument and apparatus, and second based on working principle, that is mode of chromatography. So based on instruments, we'll see there are different instruments are present for chromatography, for making or for taking the separate molecules. That is, first is column chromatography, paper chromatography, TLC is nothing but thin layer chromatography, gas chromatography, then high performance liquid chromatography, superficial chromatography, then electrophoretic chromatography. Right? So these are the different instruments or apparatus which are used for separation of the chromatographic technique. And second is based on working principle, that is adsorption chromatography, partition, ion exchange, size exclusion and miscellaneous, right? So we'll see first what is paper chromatography. So here in the image, it is shown that a glass chamber, we are using a glass chamber. In it, we are placing a paper. And at bottom, we are placing a solvent. That solvent is nothing but a mobile phase. In the image, it's shown. So here, the paper acts as a stationary phase as it is non-moving. Right, throughout the separation, the paper will remain fixed into the glass chamber. And the solvent we have used is a mobile phase, which will be moving one. Right? And in image, it is shown that colorful spots are there, visible spots, that is in green, yellow, red, orange color spots, that is nothing but the separation takes place. Okay, here the separation has taken place, so the spots are visible, right? So what we are doing initially, we are taking a filter paper, then we are making a line at the bottom with a pencil, and we are applying a drug sample on the line, right? We can apply the drug sample on the line and we can place that paper into the mobile phase. As time passes, the mobile phase runs throughout the paper, and here the separation takes place with the visible spots. So here used filter paper strips are carried and inserted into the solvent. That solvent is nothing but the mobile phase. Here the factor governing the separation of mixtures of solute on filter paper is the partition between two invisible phases. Right? This filter paper acts as a partition in between the mobile phase and a drug molecule. We have applied the drug on the paper, drug solution. So usually water adsorbs on cellulose fiber in the paper. That will be, paper is nothing but the stationary phase. And second, the organic solvent flows past the sample on the paper. So this is a basic for chromatography, that is paper chromatography. Now we'll see PLC, that is thin layer chromatography. So this is an advanced version of paper chromatography. So here, instead of paper, we are using a glass slide, that is a thin layer, right? Instead of paper, we are using a glass slide, which will act as a stationary phase. So this glass slide needs to be use a coating material, right? So here we are using a adsorbents. As I said earlier, the adsorbent to be placed on the stationary phase, right? Stationary phase, here we are using a glass slide, while in paper chromatography, the stationary phase is paper, simply paper. Then in TLC, we are using a glass slide where we are using a different adsorbents, that is silica gel, alumina or cellulose. Okay, so again, the principle is same. Here we are applying a drug solution on a pre-coated plate. Here we are using a pre-coated plate, means we are making a glass slide coating with the silica gel or alumina. Once this coating is dry, then we are applying a solution on glass slide, and we are allowing or dipping that glass slide into the stationary, into the mobile phase, sorry, into the solvent. That solvent will be a mobile phase. So we are placing the slide on the mobile phase, that is solvent, and allow the mobile phase to run throughout the stationary phase. Once the mobile phase is running through the stationary phase, the interaction between the drug molecules and mobile phase takes place in the form of visible spots or band. Chromatography madhe, either it should be a result should be in the form of band or spots. Right? Now we'll move towards HPTLC. Again, it is a sophisticated form of thin layer chromatography, that is TLC. First, we have seen paper chromatography, a very basic paper chromatography. Then we move towards the upgraded version for paper chromatography is thin layer chromatography. Then again, after a few years, we represent or we invented the HPTLC, that is high performance thin layer chromatography. So it is a sophisticated form of thin layer chromatography. It involves the same theoretical principles of thin layer chromatography. The principle of TLC and HPTLC is same. That is planar chromatography or flat bed chromatography. Then traditional thin layer chromatography and its modern instrumental quantitative analysis versions are very popular for many reasons, such as visual chromatography. Here, why this chromatography are very popular? Because here the results are visible. Okay, we can count the length, depth of the spots, whichever we have obtained in the form of results. Also, multiple samples can be applied on the HPTLC, and a low running and maintenance cost is also low for HPTLC and as well as disposable layer is also cheap. Right, so up till now we have seen paper chromatography, thin layer chromatography and high performance thin layer chromatography. Then we will see what is the basic principle for HPTLC, because the ANCHROME, this deals with HPTLC specialist. This is very renowned company for HPTLC. So now we'll see what is HPTLC. It is nothing but a similar approach for principle which is based on TLC, that is adsorption chromatography. As here we are using a adsorbent materials to get absorb the drug molecules and mobile phase. So the mobile phase solvent flows through because of the capillary action. So once we have put the stationary phase into the solvent, the mobile phase runs throughout the stationary phase. Then here the components move according to their affinity towards the adsorbents. So what material we have used for coating the plate? So depending upon that, the molecules will get absorbed on the stationary phase. That is depending upon affinity. So affinity is nothing but a liking or closeness property, right? Those molecule likes the adsorbent material, they will stay on the stationary phase. And those who hate the stationary phase, they will move faster along with the mobile phase. ठीक आहे, म्हणजे ज्या जे मॉलिक्युल्स ला स्टेशनरी फेज सोबत इंटरॅक्शन झालं आहे, दॅट विल स्टे ऑन द स्टेशनरी फेज. अँड द मॉलिक्युल्स विच, म्हणजे त्यांना ते स्टेशनरी फेज सोबत इंटरॅक्ट नाही केलंय, ते मॉलिक्युल्स मोबाईल फेज सोबत बाहेर पडतील. ठीक आहे, सो दिस इज नोन ऍज पोलॅरिटी अँड दिस विल डिपेंड अपॉन पोलर अँड नॉन पोलर. Right? Are you getting me? Affinity means what? So here the components with more affinity, that will be with the stationary phase, that will travel slow. And the compounds with a lesser affinity towards the stationary phase, that will move faster. जर त्याला स्टेशनरी फेज आवडला तर स्टेशनरी फेज सोबत राहील. राहील म्हणजेच काय होईल? इट विल गेट टाइम, तो बाहेर पडायला टाइम घेईल. And the components which has more affinity, they will stay with stationary phase, and the components which will have lesser affinity, that will move with the mobile phase faster. So in this form, the separation of the molecules will take place. So this is the separation technique of the chromatography. Thus the components are separated on the chromatographic plate. ठीक आहे, म्हणजे आपण सॅम्पल कलेक्ट करू थ्रू द मोबाईल फेज. कोणते मॉलिक्युल्स बाहेर पडतील की ज्यांना स्टेशनरी फेज सोबत थांबायचं नव्हतं ते मोबाईल फेज सोबत बाहेर पडतील, आणि ज्यांना जे इंटरॅक्शन जमलंय स्टेशनरी फेज सोबत ते स्टेशनरी फेज वर थांबतील. दॅट विल दॅट मॉलिक्युल्स विल ट्रॅव्हल स्लोअर. आर यू गेटिंग मी? नाउ this is the application or procedure for HPTLC. So here a small dot or a line of sample solution is placed on a strip of chromatography paper. Okay, as I have said earlier, we are placing a drop of drug sample solution on the stationary phase, whether the stationary phase would be paper, whether it would be a TLC or HPTLC. Then a paper or a stationary phase is placed in the jar that is containing a solvent. That solvent is nothing but the mobile phase and it is sealed. Once the jar is sealed with the mobile phase, it means the chamber is getting saturated, right? Why the chamber is getting saturated? Because the components of the mobile phase that will move in the chamber and they will produce a environment of saturation. All the molecules which are present into the mobile phase that will make a chamber saturated. Then as the solvent, then we are placing, after a chamber gets saturated, we are placing a stationary phase into the chamber. That chamber is already filled with the solvent, that is mobile phase, right? So as the solvent, when we place the stationary phase into the chamber, the solvent rises through the stationary phase. The stationary phase, again, depending upon our separation technique, it could be a paper, it could be a glass slide, or it could be a pre-coated plate. Then we are allowing the mobile phase to travel through the stationary phase. And here the mixture of the sample which starts to travel through the stationary phase with the solvent. Then the stationary phase is again made up of cellulose or a polar substances and a compounds within the mixture that travel faster, right? Again, here polarity and non-polarity concepts, we deals with the polar and non-polar molecules. So polarity means what? Equal distribution of the electric charges around the molecules or atoms is known as polarity. And polar molecules means what? The molecules which carries an unequal distribution of electronegativity charges between themselves. And polar, non-polar, that have the equal distribution of electrons is known as non-polar molecules. Okay. So here, these are the basic steps that involves in the high performance thin layer chromatography. So first we are preparing a sample. This sample can be prepared by making a powdered drug, dissolving it into a suitable solvent, and we are making a liquid. That is sample preparation. Then application of sample. As I said, we can apply a multiple samples in HPTLC. Right, then we are applying a sample onto the stationary phase. Then chromatography development, we are saturating, we are making the chamber ready. We are saturating the chamber by placing a mobile phase and seal it for half an hour before performing HPTLC or TLC or paper chromatography. Then detection of the spots. Once the spot has detected, it is scanned and documentation can be done. Then for selection of chromatography layer, here again we are selecting what types of adsorbents. So for that, pre-washing and pre-conditioning is done with the chromatographic plate, that is with the stationary phase. Okay, now we'll see what is pre-washing or pre-conditioning. Before that, we'll see what are the solvents can be used as a mobile phase in HPTLC. So here is the list of solvents, that is methanol. Methanol is very commonly used as it is a inert solvent. It is known as inert solvent. Then chloroform and methanol in the ratio of 1:1. means equal ratio. If we are taking 5 ml of chloroform, we have to take 5 ml of methanol. That is equal ratio, 1:1. Also the ethyl acetate and methanol, 1:1. Then chloroform, methanol and ammonia, that is 90:1:1. By mistake it is 0, there is 1. So chloroform 90, methanol 1, ammonia also 1. Then methyl chloride and methanol, again equal proportion, 1:1. Or also we can take 1% of ammonia or 1% of acetic acid. So these are the various solvents which can be used as a mobile phase. Now we'll see pre-coated plaque. Right, in paper chromatography, no need for pre-coating, because a paper itself acts as a stationary phase onto which the molecules will get attract or affinity to the paper. But for thin layer chromatography, we are using a glass plate, a glass slide, so which needs a coating. So the plates with a different support material and adsorbent layer with a different format and thickness are used. Again, these plates in the market are available with a different thickness, that is 100 micron to 250 micron thickness of plates are available into the market, which can be used for a qualitative purpose as well as quantitative purpose. So again, what is qualitative and quantitative? For qualitative, it will give a good standard of the drug, that will define the quality of the drug. Right, and quantity means it will give the measurement of the quantity, how much quantity, means one molecule present, two molecule present, or for synthetic, how much gram of drug is obtained, that can be count under quantity. And quality will give the standards of the quality along with the percentage of purity, how much percent purity of drug we obtain, that will defines the quality. And quantity means the amount of drug or amount of molecules present into the unknown drug sample, that defines the quantity, right? So this plays a very important role for qualitative purpose as well as quantitative purpose. Okay, now we'll see the pre-washing of pre-coated plate. As in HPTLC, we are using the plate which will be a pre-coated. So if the plate is pre-coated, to obtain an accurate result, to obtain the accuracy, we need to give the washing to the pre-coated plate. So what is the purpose for pre-washing? So here the purpose is to remove the impurities which include the water vapor, right? Whatever material we are using to make a coating, also we are using a solvent. We are making a slurry and then putting that slurry onto the stationary phase, onto the slide, glass slide. So the vapors, with the water, vapors are obtaining. So the impurities which is present, including the water vapor and other volatile substance, the atmosphere, they get exposed into the lab environment. Right, so here the silica gel 60F is most widely used adsorbent. For coating material, we are using silica gel. But here the major disadvantage of adsorbent is that it contains the iron. Right, this silica gel contains the iron as an impurity. So to remove the iron, we are using a methanol and water in the ratio 9:1. So this is the major advantage of the pre-washing of the pre-coated plates, because pre-coated plates we are using a silica gel which contains the iron as a impurities. So this if we will not pre-wash the plate, then the it will make the result vice, means the impurities will be seen in the result. So for giving the for avoiding the stresses of the iron, the we are giving wash of methanol and water in the ratio 9:1. So this is the main purpose of pre-washing of the pre-coated plate. Pre-coated plate are washed or pre-washed because to remove the impurities of iron by using a methanol and water 9:1. Again, there are different solvents which are used for pre-washing, such as methanol, again chloroform and methanol, then chloroform, methanol and ammonia. So there are different ratios for chloroform and methanol. We will use in equal ratio 1:1. And for chloroform, methanol and ammonia, 90:10:1. Now we'll see adsorbent materials. Which are the adsorbent materials are used? So silica gel, aluminium oxide, cellulose and silica gel that is chemically modified. Means two types of silica gel, which is unmodified and modified. While binders, gypsum, starch and fluorescent indicators. This can also be used in the HPTLC. Okay, now we'll see selection of HPTLC plates. As I said, there are number of plates are available depending upon the thickness. So also the hand plates are available, which are made up of cellulose and other materials which are not used now much a day. So mainly handmade plates are not used nowadays, but a small industries, if they are using a handmade plates, then they are using a cellulose material, which are made up of cellulose material. Then the plate size, this is very important, 20 into 20 centimeter. This again, various plate size are available in the market. And how to activate the plate? Once the plate is available, so activation of plates in HPTLC can be done by exposed to the high humidity or kept in the hand of long time require the activation. So this plate are preheated, they are kept into the oven for 110 degree to 120 degree Celsius for 30 minutes prior to the sample application. Application of the sample means what? Before applying the sample, we have to place the pre-coated plate into the oven for 30 minutes at 110 to 120 degree Celsius. Also, the aluminium sheets are also available. We can use that as a stationary phase. So again, this aluminium sheet can also be placed in between the two glass plate, and this sheet is also place in the oven at 110 to 120 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. Yes, Omkar, do you have any query? I will be conducting question and answer session at last. Now, preconditioning, also it is called as chamber saturation. As I said earlier, before placing the stationary phase into the chamber, we have to make the chamber saturated, right? Then selection of mobile phase. This again depends upon the polarity of the molecules or the substances. This can be done for unknown substance with trial and error basis. once who know the experiment or he has gone through the literature survey, then he can directly select the mobile phase. But for inventing a new drug or making a separation of unknown drug, we have to select the mobile phase on basis of trial and error. Okay. Then there are different applicators which are used for application of the sample. That is, first capillary tube. By using a capillary tube, we can apply a sample onto the stationary phase. And second is microbulk pipettes. With the help of pipette also, we can place the sample. And third is micro syringe. This instrument, with the help of syringe, we can apply a sample in the form of spot or band. And automatic sample applicator, this is also apply either as a spot or band. And chromatographic development and drying, once we obtain a separation on the stationary phase, we need to dry the plate or we need to dry the stationary phase. This can be done by vacuum desiccators. Okay. Then HPTLC development. There are various methods of developing the HPTLC that are vertical, vario method, horizontal development, and automatic multiple development. The Anchrom company, which is going to conduct a webinar on 10th, they are going to show you all the live demo for development of HPTLC. So these are the various chambers which are used to develop the HPTLC. This you can gain the knowledge by attending the webinar which is conducted on 10th by Anchrom. They are going to show you this through live demo, right? So due to this pandemic situation, we are unable to go offline into the industry, so we have arranged a online demo for you all, so that you can gain the knowledge, and also they are going to provide you a Anchrom certificate, which would be helpful for you in future or to in your resume, which will be of a good weightage that you have attended the Anchrom webinar or you have visited to the Anchrom virtual visit, right? So these points, development of HPTLC, that are going to show you through live demo. So these are the various chambers which can be used for development of the HPTLC. This vario chamber, this vario chromatography. Here is the instrument. Again, they are showing you the live demo for vario chamber. And last, we'll see the post chromatography step. Once we obtain the result, what we are supposed to do. So firstly, we will go for detection, then photo documentation, and then disentometry measurements. These are the post chromatography steps. So detection can be done by using a UV chamber. Once the spot, we obtain the result, then we are placing the stationary phase, like paper or thin layer chromatography. Third and final year knows this, right? So they have performed this TLC and paper chromatography. Once the result is obtained, we are placing the stationary phase into the UV cabinet to visible the result or to visible the spots, right? And then also the disentometry measurements can be done by using a UV absorption or a fluorescence, which convert the spots into chromatogram. The main disentometry measurement instrument, what this deals with, this converts the spot into chromatograms. And here is the difference between TLC and HPTLC. For TLC, handmade or pre-coated plates are available. But as HPTLC is advanced version, here pre-coated plates are available. Then the thickness of absorbent material will be 250 micrometers for TLC and HPTLC will be 100 to 200. Then particle size again in TLC 5 to 20 micrometers and for HPTLC 4 to 8 micrometers are to be done. Then pre-washing for TLC is not done in TLC, but in HPTLC it is must. Then shape for TLC only we can we can place the sample in spot, but in HPTLC spot as well as band we can put the application of the sample by band or spot. Then spot size 2 to 4 micrometers and for HPTLC 0.5 to 1. So these are all the practical parameters which you can you can understand by attending the webinar on 10th. So here we come for question and answer session. If anyone has question, they can ask me or they can put the question in chat box. Yes, any question from the participants?
Yes.
Stationary phase and the liquid phase.
Yes. So here the elution time that depends upon polarity of the molecule that is present into the drug sample, right?
Hello.
Hello.
Can you hear me?
Am I audible now, ma'am? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. So my question was, can you please tell me about elution time, like rate of elution and the separation of solute contents with respect to the affinity of a solute particles towards the stationary phase and the liquid phase?
Yes. Yes. Very good question. So here, ma'am. Okay, so here the elution time that will be depending upon the polarity of the molecules, right? So if the drug sample, if our drug, what we have to make the separation of that drug, the molecules present into the drug who have affinity towards the stationary phase, they will move slower. Because they have affinity, they love the stationary phase. So they will stay a longer time with the stationary phase and they will move slower. But the molecules who have a greater affinity towards the mobile phase, they will move along with the mobile phase faster. So depending upon the polarity of polar molecule and non-polar molecule, the elution time takes place.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am, for resolving my doubt.
Okay. Any question from participants? So today we will be going to share the link for webinar that for the first time, Ganba Sopanra Mosey College of Pharmacy is going to collaborate with the industry, that is Ancrome Enterprises Private Limited, Mumbai. So once you have to go through the registration link, you have to do the registration as you have done for the pre-webinar, same in the same format, the link is there. You have to make the registration and they are going to provide you the certificate for Ancrome company. Zankrom company is very renowned in pharmaceutical industry. So it would be helpful for you in the future to also in the resume. Yes, I have got the question from YouTube that blood test can be done in chromatography. Blood test means not the what kind of test, means blood samples can be studied under chromatography. But what test you are asking, can you elaborate? The participant from the YouTube, he has asked me blood test can be done. So blood samples can be studied, biological samples can be studied through chromatography, right? So all the biological samples such as urine, blood, plasma, sputum, stools, all biological samples can be studied through chromatography. I hope I have cleared your question, because I'm not getting what test you are asking me, blood test. But blood samples can be done. Yes. Okay, one more question, drawbacks of chromatography. So as such, I said earlier, paper chromatography, TLC, they have some limitations. Because they are very traditional technique, right? On paper, again, some of the molecules which we are applying on the paper that can get dissolved, means paper can get dissolved, means it can get interact with the blood sample, with the results. So the drawbacks for chromatography is just it takes a time, means it's a time consuming process for paper and TLC, but HPTLC is an advance for it. Okay, Dipanshu, I hope I have cleared with your doubt.
Yes, ma'am.
Drawback is just limitations, that time consuming and the material we are using as a stationary phase. Okay, so again, on behalf of Principal Sir, I request you all that you make your registration here so that the Ankrom company will provide you a certificate, which could be helpful for you in future. And for today's webinar also, we are going to issue you certificates. Once you will fill the feedback form, we will be circulating a feedback form link. You have to fill the feedback forms. Once you submit the feedback form, you will receive a e-certificate, which will be a printable. Right? So it is a very good startup for all the first year, second year from degree and diploma, for collecting the knowledge as well as certificates, which would be helpful for you in future. So the flyer for webinar on 10th will be circulating today. So before 10, you make a registration. Make sure you have registered, because the registration link, the company will be sending a registration link to only registered participants. So each and every student should register themselves through the link before 10 of March. And that webinar will be conducting by the speaker Dr. Manjusha Phanse. Application of specialist. All right. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I request Ms. Tesha Bhosle, Assistant Professor in Ginwa College of Pharmacy, Wagholi, to give a vote of thanks.
Thank you, Madhuri ma'am. Ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon to all. It gives me an immense pleasure to deliver the vote of thanks for today's webinar to all the dignitaries present here. I would love to thank Mugdha Nandedkar madam for all of us for illuminating all of us with your knowledge and thoughts on chromatography. I would like to thank our beloved principal Rajesh Oswal sir and Saili Budhwan madam and Nikhil Bhujbar sir for coordinating this professor, and last but not the least, our dear students for making this webinar a great success. Once again, I thank one and all for your presence. Thank you so much. Please we request you to fill up the feedback form and submit them to us. We'll be providing you all, as Mugdha madam said, e-certificates. Those will be given. And kindly register for the next webinar so that you can get access to the webinar. And for that also, you'll be getting certificates. And a nice demo of the HPLC that will obviously add up your knowledge. Okay? Thank you so much. So we are looking forward for your presence. For on 10th of March, on techniques and application of HPTLC in pharma and herbal drugs, which could be delivered by a speaker, Dr. Manjusha Phanse, ma'am, which is application specialist. Feedback link will be shared on the YouTube channel later. Once you will submit the feedback link, you will be receiving a e-certificate, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, participants. Now you can leave the meeting.
Thank you, ma'am.
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 Thank you, ma'am. Okay. Ma'am. Thank you, 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 ma'am. Yo te puedo decir que